Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Nullish coalescing operator. What does it mean by this operator? It just returns the first non-null or defined expression. So in this video, I'm going to discuss its difference from the OR operator. Many people have some misunderstanding between these two operators, so I'm going to talk about it in this video. Now, let us see the HTML file first. It is just a very simple HTML file that contains a title and a heading. And this HTML file is going to connect to the JavaScript file, which is in the JS folder. And the file name is called myscript.js. And we can see that the JS folder is simply at the same level of the HTML file. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about the JavaScript file. The JavaScript file is something like this one. Because I want to use the strict mode, I simply say use strict at the very beginning of the JavaScript file. Then I'm going to talk about the nullish coalescing operator. So the nullish coalescing operator is going to return the first non-null or defined expression. So let us see an example of this meaning. When we have this kind of expression, a equals null ?0, what will I get? Now this example is what we call the nullish coalescing operator. We use two question marks to represent this operator. Since the operator returns the first non-null or defined expression, we can expect that we will get 0 as the answer. Is that the case? Let us see the result by printing it out. Save. Reload. Yes, I get 0 because the first value is a null value, N-U-L-L, okay? And since the nullish coalescing operator returns the first non-null expression, I will get the second one as the answer to this relation, okay? So the reason is like this one. I will get 0 because 0 is the first non-null or defined value of the relation on the right-hand side. Okay, so that is the reason why I will get 0 as the answer. So now I'm going to set up another example. Now I have a variable called age, but age is not assigned a value to it. In this situation, the variable is simply called an undefined variable. So if I want to print it out, I can see something like this one. Save. Reload. Yes, I will get undefined as the answer coming from the age variable. So how about this kind of comparison? If I want to do the nullish coalescing operation between age and 0, which is a number, we will actually get 0 as the answer because the first one is an undefined expression. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to return the second value, which is actually a non-null or defined expression. So let me save it and run it. I will get 0 because 0 is actually the first defined expression of the entire one shown here. Okay. So 0 is returned because it is the first non-null or defined value. Okay, that's the reason. And let's see another example that discusses the difference between the nullish coalescing operator and the OR operator. So we have to be pretty sure that the nullish coalescing operator is not the same as the OR operator, which is represented by two vertical lines or what we call two pipes. The reason is like this one. the OR operator simply gives me the first truthy value, but 0, false, empty strings are regarded as falsy values. Also, the null value, undefined value are also falsy values. So if we meet these two values with the OR operator, we will simply ignore them and we will try to test whether the upcoming expressions can be returned by the OR operator. So let us see an example like this one. So B is equal to this expression, empty string OR 8. So let me see the effect of printing the value of B out. Save. Reload. I will get 8 as the answer. The reason is quite simple. The empty string is known as the falsy value, but the OR operator does not return the first falsy value. It just returns the first truthy value. And 8 is regarded as a truthy value because it is not equal to one of these cases. 0, false, empty string, null, or undefined. So 8 is regarded as a truthy value, and the OR operator represented by two pipes simply returns the first truthy value, and now 8 is the first truthy value of the entire expression. So I will get 8 as the answer. So that's the reason why we have to distinguish between the OR operator and the Nullish coalescing operator. If I'm using the Nullish coalescing operator instead of the OR operator, the situation will be different. So let me see an example right now. So I changed the OR operator to the Nullish coalescing operator. Save. Reload. Now I will get the empty string as the answer to the expression. The reason is that the empty string is not regarded as the null value or the undefined value. Since this one is not regarded as any one of these two values, I've simply printed out as the answer to the Nullish coalescing operation. Okay, so in this case, I will get the empty string as the answer instead of printing out 8 as the answer. So we can see that the OR operator and the Nullish coalescing operator are quite different. Okay, that's the reason why we have to learn the difference between these two kinds of operators. Let us see another example that illustrates this idea even further. I'm going to set up a variable as follows. This is a pretty long expression. I want to see the value of C that is accepted finally. Now, ?? Undefined, ?? False, ?? A string called hello. What will we get as the answer? Let us see. Save. Reload. I will get false actually. The reason is that the first value is null and the second value is undefined. The Nullish coalescing operator simply wants to give me the first non-null or defined value. So in this case, I will go to the third one, which is false. So false is not regarded as null or undefined. So in this case, this becomes the first non-null or defined expression. Okay, so that's the reason why I get false instead of the previous two expressions. Okay. We can see another example that tells the difference between the Nullish coalescing operator and the OR operator. How about this one? I just connect the previous four expressions with the OR operators. Okay. Null, OR, undefined, OR, false, OR, string, hello. What do I get when I use all the OR operators in this expression? Let me see the result by saving it first, and then I just reload the page. I will get hello, because hello is regarded as the first true fee value of the entire expression. So null and undefined are both regarded as the false value. Of course, false is also a false value. So that's why we go to the first true fee value, which is this one. Okay. So that's why we will say hello as the answer. One final thing to talk about is the precedence issue of the Nullish coalescing operator. It is actually having a pretty low preference. So if we want to use the Nullish coalescing operator, it is quite sensible for us to use brackets in the expression. So the use of brackets is highly recommended or suggested. Let us see an example that illustrates this idea. Now I have two variables E and F. What's the result of this entire expression? E question mark question mark Java plus F question mark script. So in order to handle the Nullish coalescing operator first, I have to use a pair of brackets to include the expression. Now E and F are just undefined variables. We want to return the first undefined value, so I will get Java in the first pair of brackets. Same for the other pair of brackets, I will get script, because F is a really undefined variable. So let us see the result. Save. Reload. Yes, I will get JavaScript, because the plus sign here is going to just join the two strings together. So I will have JavaScript without any space between the two words. Okay. So E and F are just undefined values, and the Nullish coalescing operators are going to return the first non-nullish or defined expression. That's the reason why I will get JavaScript. That's the answer. The reason is just that E and F are really undefined. In this case, we go to the first defined expression. So I will have Java and script respectively. And then after I join them together, I've got JavaScript as the answer. So this video has already talked about the meaning of the Nullish coalescing operator shown here. And I've also discussed many examples that involve the operation of the Nullish coalescing operator. And I'm also able to discuss the difference between the Nullish coalescing operator and the OR operator. And I've also mentioned the issue of the preference pertaining to the Nullish coalescing operator. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.